fact that we want to explore this whole dungeon and get to where that fourth pillar is. Which we haven't done yet. Ooh, rope, new enemy. They mainly just kind of start dashing at you when they see you. Not anything really all that out of the ordinary. Right here, we are going to need to hit the crystal switch if we want to go through there, because we can walk atop the crystal switch. Dang, my shield really covers a lot of my body. Let me go ahead and do that really quick just so I can take care of that. So, yeah, Link's Awakening is coming to a close. We have six of the eight instruments of Sirens. The windfish is stirring in its sleep, and at this point, I feel like it's kind of good to talk about it. Like I said, I feel like it's how you live in the time, you're in the timeless island, Mara seems to be the only person with any desire to see what's beyond the ocean. Nobody seems to know what is beyond it. It's such a fascinating concept to me. And, you know, I mean, heck, we're hatching a big fish from an egg. You can take that and also the fact that we are essentially hatching a fish from an egg, and we don't even know what it is or what it looks like. The fact that I heard the music sound, I'm like, oh crap, that's that room. So we want to spin attack and didn't get it. Okay, let's you and let's okay, there we go. Hit it. Now you notice I made a chest appear over there. Can't get to it. You're gonna have to drop down from above if you want it. Now, it's really, really jerkish for them to give you that chest. Grab a wrecking ball, and here we have another fight with Phenox, Cyclops. We have the bomb to worry about. Well, at least I found out the hole that lets me collect the treasure chest up here, so I guess I can show this. Silver lining, I think positively. Let's just grab this, and it's 20 pointless rupees that we don't need. Joy. I'll meet you guys back over at Hinox's room. Woo!
We'll be right back.